Hi everyone, I'm Zach Reinhardt, here to review the new Toddle record, Vacantly. Toddle is a band that's been around since the mid-2000s, and they are kind of one of the legacy bands of Number Girl after they broke up. Tabachi Hisako, the guitarist of Number Girl after they broke up, left and went to join the Bloodthirsty Butchers, which is another incredibly important band from the 90s. And she also formed her own band, Toddle. The Bloodthirsty Butchers is a long-running indie rock band from Japan that's put out just a ton of albums. They're still together, and they are really a hugely just very influential band. They had a heavy, very meaty sound with a lot of feedback in it, and it was very kind of intentionally somewhat roughly produced. But the songs were also very catchy, they were somewhat poppy, it was accessible to the average listener, and they really kind of straddled this line of like really heavy underground stuff and more light, easy to listen to kind of poppy rock music. I highly recommend their album Kokorono from 1996. It's very good. It's got a big Big Muff fuzz pedal on the front of it, which is the same pedal I use, though obviously a newer model. And then Number Girl came along much later than the Bloodthirsty Butchers and put out four albums and a couple live albums over the course of a few years that took a similar sound to what the Bloodthirsty Butchers was doing, but made it much more distorted, made it more aggressive, made it more angsty. And I think Number Girl was one of the best bands to ever come out of Japan. I highly recommend really all their albums. I guess Schoolgirl Distortional Addict would be the kind of agreed upon best one, though I personally like Sapuke more, but that's just me. And so when Toddle was formed, I of course followed their career because I follow all of the Number Girls members' careers. And I've always kind of thought of Toddle as being kind of like the Bloodthirsty Butchers light. Their songs are fairly easy to listen to, they're kind of poppy, but they have that same kind of feedbacky, kind of heavy quality to them that is reminiscent of those 90s and early 2000s bands. But they lack the kind of raw, unrestrained brilliance that the Bloodthirsty Butchers and Number Girl had. They're just decent. And now we skip forward a few years to today, and they've got a new album out. This is their fourth album, and not a huge amount has changed, though their sound has definitely modernized a bit since that first record. Track two, Beat Rotates, is a good track to kind of talk about to exemplify what the album as a whole sounds like. It has these very busy drums that are very well performed and filled with a lot of energy, but the production, for whatever reason, seems like intent on making them a background instrument. So the drums are a little bit neutered, but they're still very kind of busy and energetic despite that. And the guitars have this very kind of fuzzy, slightly reverby kind of feedbacky tone that is really exactly in the middle between the kind of older early 2000s sounds that Toddle draws on and really was a part of, and the modern kind of sparkling reverb sheen that you hear on a lot of current indie pop and indie rock records, especially coming out of Tokyo. There's some really good guitar tone on here. The lead guitar has some very good melodies and just a really nice kind of fuzzed out tone to it. And there's a really good guitar solo towards the end of it. But sadly, the song's writing is just kind of okay. While there are these kind of moments of highlight and brilliance, there's a lot of space between those moments that's just kind of dime a dozen indie rock. This song doesn't really stick with me after I'm done listening to it. I don't really find myself thinking about this song or remembering it or humming its melodies as I go about my day. And the vocals are kind of flat, kind of plain, passionless, and there's really no just emotion behind them. They sound a lot better when there's a harmony going on with the vocals, but when it's just one voice, it's just kind of plain and flat and kind of boring. And this song isn't bad, but it isn't good either. It's kind of squarely in the okay area. It's just a decent track, and while there are these highlight moments and these kind of flashes of really good performance on the instrumental, it's somewhat neutered by the production, and the vocals are just kind of flat and emotionless, and the songwriting is unmemorable. And that, to a large degree, is pretty much the whole record. As much as the vocals bother me at a lot of points on this album, they're not really a huge, consistent problem for listening, but I feel like the biggest flaw is the songwriting. Even my favorite songs on here, I don't really find myself thinking about a lot afterwards. I don't remember them. They don't get stuck in my head. I don't really have any moments where like a really good chorus sticks out to me and I'm like, oh wow, that's a really fun chorus and I want to sing along or something like that. Like the songs all kind of come across as okay. Just through their songwriting. There's really not much originality to them either. A fair amount of this album also has its head kind of just stuck in the past. There's a lot of sounds that are really directly drawn from the kind of 90s and early 2000s indie sound. But they're glossed up with a modern production style that I feel doesn't really improve upon them or compliment them all that well. The production is very clean, everything is mixed very well, but I feel that it takes a little bit of the passion out of the music. The songs are not as engaging as the music that they are very clearly trying to draw from. When I listen to most of this album, especially tracks like Right Hand Drive, especially, and Bitter Hours is another one that's very kind of stuck in the past. When I listen to these tracks, I can hear in my head what they would have sounded like 15 years ago. And the case is always that they would have sounded better. Once again, I'm not trying to be really negative about this record. There are good qualities here, and while I think the vocals do get pretty bad on like the track Parallel Lines especially, they're not horrible. And most of these songs are either just all right to pretty solid. You know, there's no bad tracks on here. I'm not trying to say this album is just horrible and there's no redeeming qualities. There's a lot of good ideas here, and there's a lot of good working parts, but they're kind of all spaced out between these moments of just really samey, kind of typical stuff. My favorite song on this record is track 7, Stir, which is the only song on here that really kind of just is having fun. It's not trying to draw from these old sounds so directly, and it's just doesn't take itself very seriously. It's upbeat, it's very bubbly. It is probably the best chorus on here, and it has some really just beautiful guitar parts. Especially right after the chorus, there's this dual guitar part that is kind of soaked in reverb and very slightly distorted. And it just sounds very pretty. It sparkles in the song. This song also has one of the better vocal performances and is one of the better written songs on here. But even this track is not very memorable and catchy. Like I couldn't hum the melody to you, and I just listened to it a few minutes ago. Overall, this album is okay. It's got its moments of brilliance, and it also has its moments of boredom. It has its roots and at sometimes its whole head in the past, but it also draws upon modern sounds and modern production. The album isn't bad, but it is a little disappointing. And I'm feeling a 6.5 out of 10. If you're not familiar with the kind of older bands that I mentioned, first of all, I highly recommend you check them out. They're very good. But also, this album might work as a good kind of transition piece from modern indie rock into the older stuff, as it has a modern edge to it, but it is definitely drawing from the older 90s, early 2000s sounds. But yeah, that's me. So, new Toddle record. It's called Vacantly. You can pick it up on Amazon.co.jp. I'm sure it's on CD Japan as well. People ask me all the time where to buy these records. So, check those sites first. Those should be your first stops. But yeah, this record is all right. It's got its moments of greatness, but overall, I find it to be a little disappointing. But yeah. Peace.